Okay, so now that we understand what mixers are and why we might want to use them, in this lecture, I want to show you how to actually use one to break the connection between transactions and use Bitcoin in a more anonymous manner. I'm going to use a mixer called Mixtum in this example, but using these mixers is pretty much the same. So by the end of this lecture, you should be able to apply this knowledge to use any mixer you want. So, we're going to click on Mix My Coins to start mixing. And as you can see right now, it's asking us for the address that will receive the payments. So this is the address of the second wallet, of this wallet right here. And this is an extra option that we have here in Mixtum where we can actually add another address. So we receive the coins in two different addresses, again, making it even more difficult to track. But I'm just going to use one address. So I'm sending coins to this wallet. As you can see, the balance is zero. And in order to receive coins in here, as shown before, we go to the Receive tab and we copy the address here. I'm going to paste it and send. And as you can see right now, it's telling us that we should send the money to this address. Now, this is the address of Mixtum, the address of the mixer. So what we're doing right here, this is the address of this right here. And what we're going to do is we're going to transfer money from our first wallet to the mixer. And then the mixer will do its magic, mix in our coins, and finally forward the coins to the address that we already gave it, the address of the first wallet. So what I need to do right now is copy this and go to the wallet that I want to send money from, which is this wallet right here. As you can see, the balance is 2 micro bitcoins. We're going to go on send. We're going to set the pay to address to the address of the mixer. You can set a description. It doesn't really matter. I'm going to send the maximum possible amount, and I'm going to keep the fee the same. Now, you want to keep in mind, you send more than the minimum allowed amount. So if we go up to our mixer, you can see the minimum allowed amount is 0.001 Bitcoin. So multiply that by 1,000. And that means 1 micro Bitcoin is the minimum amount that you can mix. If you send less than that, it'll either be lost or considered as a donation. The minimum amount differs depending on the mixer you're using. So whenever you're using a mixer, make sure you're always sending more than the minimum amount. So now that we're happy with everything, I'm going to click on send. It's going to ask me for the password. And the payment is sent right now. So if we look at my history, you can see that the balance of this wallet is going to go down by -2 micro Bitcoins. But if you look at the history here, we still don't see the unconfirmed transaction. Remember, previously when we transferred money between two wallets, we immediately saw that the receiving wallet received an unconfirmed transaction, and after a while, this transaction became confirmed. Now, we don't see it in this case, because what we did right now, we didn't send money directly from this wallet to this one right here. We sent the money to the mixer. Right here, the mixer is going to do its magic. It's going to mix the bitcoins, make it harder to trace, and then and only then it'll send it back to the receiving wallet, which is this one right here. Now, the time of mixing differs depending on the mixer and depending on how it works. With Mixtum, it can take a maximum of 6 hours, so you want to be patient with it until you receive the amount. You might also receive the amount in smaller chunks, so you might not receive the whole amount in one transaction. So just be patient with it until you receive the full amount that you transferred. And keep in mind that there is a transfer fee and there is a fee taken by the mixer, again, depending on the mixer itself. Okay, now I'm back at my Tails machine. Now, this is actually after about 20 hours. But if you look at the legacy wallet in here, you can see that we received our coins here from the Tumblr. So first we received 1 micro Bitcoin, and then we received 0.7 micro Bitcoin. So as you can see, it did not come as one full payment. Now, I know I said I'm back after more than 20 hours, but if you look at the time of receiving this, it's only about 3 hours after the time when we sent the coins to the mixer. So it took about 3 hours. Like I said, it can take a maximum of 6 hours for mixed them, but the time vary depending on the mixer that you're using. So right now, the coins that we have in here in our John Wick wallet have been mixed and have been cleaned and will be harder to trace than normal coins because we broke the connection from the previous wallet that sent these coins. Like I said, this will make it harder to trace and make us more anonymous, but it's still not the best and the most ideal coin to use if anonymity and privacy are very important. A better solution would be to use a coin that's designed from the ground up to be private and anonymous, and we'll talk more about that in the next lectures. I just wanted to cover this here because a lot of people and a lot of websites still use Bitcoin because Bitcoin is the most popular cryptocurrency, as we all know.